Hey guys, this is Ben, and I and Andy are in Dallas. We're not here this week, so I've got a bunch of the small group leaders subbing in for me. A little later on, Zach Day is going to share with you guys his story. Today we're talking about dating, which all of you guys are all intrigued about. And as I was thinking about this idea of dating, my first thought went to a mentor of mine, someone in my life that I deeply admire and love, and his words of wisdom to me on this idea of dating, especially in high school. His name is Lionel Richie. I don't know if you guys know him. Some of the leaders in this room might know him, but I can't think of any better way than to let you hear words of wisdom from him through me. So hopefully you will enjoy this. This is for you on dating. Wow, that got awkward real quick. Sorry about that. Anyway, what can we learn from Lionel Richie when it comes to dating? I actually have a picture of Lionel Richie here. Check it out. There's Lionel Richie, sweet fro. If I had a mustache like that, I would be hot stuff. I don't think I'd ever stop looking at myself in the mirror if I looked like this, to be honest. But Lionel Richie, cheesy music dude from the past. Ask your leaders about him. Some of your leaders might love Lionel Richie like I do, but we can actually learn a lot of stuff about dating from Lionel Richie. The first thing we can learn from Lionel Richie is don't date based on looks. For us, this is naturally a thing we do. We look at the girls or the other guys in our grade or in our school, and we say, you know what, that chick's hot, or that dude's pretty good looking, or whatever you say, we date based on that. And yes, looks are important, but if you date solely based on looks, you're probably not going to last that long. You're going to find out that really personality, obviously their faith, and just who they are in general, whether you enjoy get along with them, is way more important than what they look like. So Lionel, sorry dude, you're wrong. It's not all about looks. The second thing we can learn from Lionel is don't date because you're lonely. Lots of people do this. We find all of our friends are dating. I remember when Pam and I got married fairly young, and a lot of our friends were single, but we find now that we're older that most of our friends are married, and we've got a few friends that aren't, it can be a lonely place just to see that everyone else is dating. So maybe you're in the same spot in your high school, everyone's dating except for you, and you feel lonely, you feel kind of left out. Don't date based on that. God tells us that we need to... we need to respect ourselves, we need to love ourselves and who we are in Him before we can even think about loving other people. So my encouragement to you is to not date because you're lonely. There's my Dr. Phil moment for you. The third thing is don't become jealous within dating. I see this a lot. I see a dude and a girl start dating, and one of them is really jealous. I see them restricting the other person from who they can hang out with. If they start talking with another girl or another guy, they get really jealous about it and they're insecure within that. Don't let jealousy ruin a great relationship. This is something that happens a lot in high school, and it's normally just petty bitterness that I see, but don't let that get in the way. And then finally, what we can learn from Lionel is guard your hearts and your minds. He talks a lot about the way that he dreams of her, kissing her 1,000 times, and I know that's super cheese, but we need to realize that when you get into a dating relationship, lots of times you need to not only guard yourself physically, setting up parameters and boundaries when you're with that person, but also your mind. For Pam and I, we started dating when we were in college. She was a freshman, I was a sophomore, and by God's grace, we did fairly well purity-wise. We made our mistakes, we slipped up, we crossed some of our boundaries for sure, and we had to repent of that, and we had to see the consequences of that, but we did fairly well. But I know for me personally, I did not do very well in my mind. I allowed my mind to stray a lot. I allowed my thoughts of Pam to get to a bad place fairly frequently, and I actually found a correlation to how I was doing in my mind and how we were doing physically together. When I was allowing my mind to stray, my body would follow. So if we're hanging out, watching a movie, and in my mind I'm doing all kinds of stuff that I shouldn't be, I would be attracted to do that to her and with her. When we're watching the movie too, just because that's just naturally how we work. So I believe that's probably the best advice I can give you is just guard your mind. Yes, it's a secret place. People don't know about it. It's easy to get away with stuff. But realize that the consequences are fairly strong. If you fall there, lots of times you'll fall externally as well. And we talked a little bit about that last week when it came to lust too. So that's kind of what I... what I have for you. I'm sure that Zach's going to follow up with a lot of the same things, but I want you to welcome Zach Day to the stage. He is a young dude that loves Jesus and is in a dating relationship with one of our other small group leaders, Katie, and I invited him just to come and share with you guys a little bit of his heart and his thoughts when it comes to dating. So come on up, Zach. See ya.